form and translations that sound like a wandering monk poet. The next thing we're going to do is based on a composition by Bill Evans called Peace, Peace. I want to give you a little background about the composition before we start. Before Bill Evans joined Miles Davis, he put together this unrehearsed composition for the 1958 album Everyone Digs Bill Evans, with Sam Jones on bass and Philly Joe Jones on drums. But this particular piece, Peace Peace, was a solo that was put on the album. The song was inadvertently developed when he tried to create an introduction to Leonard Bernstein's Some Other Time from West Side Story. Once when he was playing in a club gig, Evans just tacked on a little solo, Peace Peace, at the end of the set. And afterwards, a teenage fan rushed up to the piano and told Bill Evans that when he heard it, he felt like he was standing all alone in New York. And Bill Evans looked a little puzzled. I've always liked this piece, but it came back to me when I saw this film called Jack Goes Boating with Philip Seymour Hoffman. It was a matinee, so, you know, like most matinees are, there's like three people in the room. And they used Bill Evans' Peace Peace in the soundtrack. And at the end of the film, as the credits ran, all you could hear was Peace Peace played in its entirety, and it turned that movie theater into a cathedral. And I love the way the sound resonates in an empty theater. Anyway, one thing is, though often requested, it was a very popular tune. Evans usually would decline to play it because he said that it had been kind of the inspiration of the moment and not something that could be repeated. And I think that's a mark of a great artist, that he doesn't want to repeat himself. So we're going to do this piece for Bill Evans, Scott LaFaro, and Paul Motian, one of my favorite Bill Evans groups. It's called Peace Peace. For peace. Louis Armstrong and his cornet chop suey. I guess I should kind of sketch out the little history of this song. The turn of the century, 1910 and into the 20s, Tin Pan Alley was alive with songwriters. And it also was a time when America, the media, was obsessed with things Chinese. So you get these songs like, Chinky Chinky Butterfly, or Chinatown, My Chinatown, written by Tin Pan Alley songwriters. Where the Lights Are Low is written by William Jerome and Gene Schwartz in 1910. And I think it's one of the first songs that they really tried to transpose an Asian scale into a Western package, you know. And, you know, I think that's probably what was the draw for a lot of jazz musicians. I mean, this song's been recorded over 50 times and counting. Probably my favorites are by the Mills Brothers, where they supply their own horns with their voices. Chris Connor and Louis Armstrong. Most of the jazz musicians had the discretion of just singing the most, benign parts of these lyrics. I went and looked at the original lyrics, and it goes something like this: when the town is fast asleep and it's midnight in the sky, that's time the festive chink starts to wink his other eye. Starts to wink his dreaming eye, lazily you'll hear him sigh. The strangers taking in the sights, pigtails flying here and there. See that broken Wall Street sport, still thinks he's a millionaire. Still thinks he's a millionaire, pipe dreams vanish. Every care. Chinatown, my Chinatown, where the lights are low, hearts that know no other land, drifting to and fro, dreamy, dreamy Chinatown. Almond eyes of brown, hearts seem light and life seems bright in dreamy Chinatown. So I was kind of conflicted when I wrote this poem. I wanted to celebrate my admiration for the gusto and the joy that Louis Armstrong brings to the plate, to the trumpet, to his voice. But I also wanted to make it kind of a lament for the way Chinatown, like Las Vegas, has been betrayed. You know, the place where you go to party and maybe do some things that aren't particularly legal, but it's all washed out by the morning. I don't know if I succeeded in getting both into this poem, but we're gonna do this poem. Where the Lights Are Low. Dancing. Shoelaces unlace. squirm out of a straitjacket of holes. Canvas tongues jump up and scat. Doom's business falls in a rag pile, lined with bones of defeated dinosaurs. Rats wait to devour what's left. The music is a steamroller, smoking orange blades of joy. That slice open cantaloupes, gut the cheeks of tomatoes, tomato, a tisket, a tasket, a little yellow basket. The nastiest notes gouge me behind the eyes. Pepper me with innuendo, spilling sparks of fireflies into the fabric of the night. Up against the wall, ready to wail. The words finally surface through a melody sung like sandpaper. Chinatown, my Chinatown, where the lights are low. Chinatown, my Chinatown, where the lights